Yo, 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 it's your new friend Omawale. Welcome back as we look at the world through African eyes. Today, we're going to remember a nation that we have forgotten, the Wagadu Empire, also known as the Ghana Empire. Let's begin. In Africa, gold grows in the sand like carrots do, and is picked at sunrise. Located in today's southwest Mali and southeast Mauritania, it sprung from the culture of the Soninke people, a northern Mende-speaking group that rose to power thanks to their skills of iron smelting. These people were the main people force within the kingdom and later empire, a realm shrouded in mystery to most people, until the mentions by sources like al-Bakri, al-Idrisi, Ibn Khaldun, Mahmud Kati, and others. Thanks to these sources, we can now delve into specifics of this society, like the kingship, the dresses of the people, the military, sources of wealth, and spirituality. The kingdom of Wagadu was ruled by the Ghana, a version of Kaya Magan, meaning Lord of Gold, alluding to the great source of wealth of the kingdom. Al-Bakri mentioned the names of two former rulers, King Bessi and King Tunka Manin. However, since Al-Bakri had an outsider's view of the kingdom, he was bound to make some mistakes, such as the name of the king during 1067 as Tunka Manin. His name was actually Manin, Tunka being a noble title, perhaps meaning something similar like a prince. And during this time, the kingship came through the female line, which is a distinguishing feature compared to the modern Mende-speaking people, who place emphasis on patrilineal descent. You had to be the son of the king's sister to become the next in line for the kingship of Wagadu. So basically, we don't know if matrilineal descent was specific to the royal family, while the common people traced their lineage through their fathers. Still, we can say that women had an important role to kingship, similar to other nations in West Africa.